शारिया
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 यस एंड देन योर स्ट्रीट नेम व्हाट एवर इट इज लाइक समवन इज लिविंग ऑन मेन स्ट्रीट पिशारे मेन एंड देन बी फ्रिस्को बी फ्रिस्को
द शार इज नेम
द शार इज नेम एंड देन योर सिटी नेम बी आफ्टर शारे आफ्टर शारे द नेम ऑफ द स्ट्रीट एंड देन बी फ्रिस्को और बी ग्लेनो व्हाट
इज बी ऑफ
बी बी फ्रिस्को एंड अगेन यू आर फ्री टू यूज फी एज वेल Instead of B, either you say Bifrisco, this one Bifrisco or Fi Frisco. Both of them are okay. Any question? Please ask me if you need to clarify.
Askun is live.
Yeah, Askun, I live. So if you remove Ana again. And just say Askun, that will be also okay. Grammatically, the word Askun is the verb. Verb. Like, at present I live.
Yes.
It will not serve the purpose if you want to say I used to live. Then we have another word for that. Or I'm going to live in future. Then we have some more addition to this word. So Askun is presenting your current situation. Sukoon. Yes.
Why we use Hamza of Alif?
Yes, we have this discussion.
Yeah.
Alif and Hamza discussion, but it will come in unit 3. So I want to and I want to.
But if I write, and I'll just put one zabar.
Yes, yes. So inshallah.
Hamza is a complicated.
Yes, it is a detailed discussion. So I don't want to. Right now, start this discussion. So everyone wrote it down this line. Ana Askun Fi Share. Okay, you take your street name.
Inshallah. Ana Askun Fi Share Cowboy Trail.
Okay. Fi Frisco. Or Bi Frisco.
Fi Frisco, Fi Texas.
Or Texas, yes, very good.
Ana Askun Fi Share Stephenville. Bi Frisco.
Very good.
Ana Askun Fi Share Skita Lane, Fi Frisco.
Very good. Now, the wonderful thing is that though Arabic is very delicate language in terms of the gender use, there are different words for the male, different word for the female in the verbs also. But there are only two forms of the verb that they are common. A man also will say Ana Askun. And a woman also will say an askun. There will be no difference in the word.
An askun fi share El Dorado fi Frisco.
Very good.
An askun fi share Hickory fi.
Very good. Wonderful.
An askun share
Springfield.
Yes. Very good. Frisco or McKinney? Frisco. Okay, very good. Now here, if you would like, you can add the word Madinat also again. Like Share. Fi Madinat Frisco, Fi Madinat McKinney, Fi Madinat Pileno. You can say that way also. Yes.
Coney Island Drive, Frisco.
Okay, very good.
So I have a question. Earlier you said Ala is on. So why is it not on street versus English?
Yes. Actually, English expression, these are the, you know, the language used. In English we say on. But we do not translate the same way in Arabic. We will say in Arabic fi, because on Arabic on or ala gives you the impression that something on the top of that, right? On the top of that, like this laptop is on the table, so it's on the top of that. So we are not living on the top of that, we are living in the street. So this is the difference of the use of two languages. Yes.
Anaskun fi share shandrai fi
kriska. Okay.
Anaskun fi share rai fi kriska.
Very good, very good. You use the word Madinat also.
You're making me difficult for me. Right?
No, not difficult.
Anas kun fi share imperial medal min Madina fi Texas.
Fi Madina Frisco, Texas.
Anas kun fi share Harvard fi Madina Frisco.
Okay, very good.
Anas kun fi share Louis Bogart fi Frisco.
Okay, so hold on to this table. I'll move through this table, then we'll come back over here. Yes. Yes. Good job. No, fi. She said fi. Very good. Yes.
Yes.
Bileno, yes. Yes, move to the next
one. Ana school fi share Naomi fi Madinati Frisco, Texas.
Just say fi Madinat.
Fi Madinat
Frisco, Texas. You don't need to put any vowel of the on Madinat, yes.
Ana school fi share fi Madinat.
Very good.
I have a question.
Now,
how do you say south?
South?
South. South. Direction.
South. South is Junub.
Junub.
Junub. Junub. Yes.
So south wave crest would be what?
South wave.
Wave crest. Wave crest is the name.
So Junub wave crest.
Junub wave crest.
Yes.
And Askun Pishahare.
Fishare,
Junub
wave crest,
Vi
Madinati,
Litilan.
Very good. Good job. Yes. There is no ha. In Urdu, we say Shahre. Like Shahre. But in this one, it's Shahre.
These are two different words. In Arabic, it's Shahre with Ayn in the end. And Urdu, we say Shahra. Then we have the ha. This ha. So in Arabic, no ha.
So we have to pay attention that we are not saying Shahra.
No.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Okay. Yeah. We are in Arabic, we are using only this word Shari'. And I will remember the Ayn sound in the Ayn. Shari'.
It has to be Shari or Shara. We don't say also Shara. Shara.
Yeah. In spoken Arabic, they say Shara also, so it's okay. But this is the formal word, Shari'.
Shari'.
Yes. Yeah. Ana askun fi ishare.
Ana askun fi ishare. Volcam road.
Bi Madina.
Bi Madina.
Frisco.
Ana askun fi ishare. Single drive. Bi Madina. Frisco, Texas.
Yes, in this sense, road, as he said, it will be Share. Okay. So, please add this line of your residence with your introduction. So, next time when we will do, we will start the introduction from the beginning. Ahlan wa sahlan, then ana ismi, and then you will complete with this line of the Share also. Okay. Yes.
Is this classic element?
Yes, not classic, modern standard. No, not Egyptian.
Modern
it
standard.
Is formal Arabic. Like, that is, as I told you, that is the language of the newspapers and magazines and all that. So, we will use the term formal, and we call it Fusha. In Arabic, we say it Fusha. I'm writing the word Fusha in Arabic and in English as well, so that you can write it in some translation. Now look at this word. In English, when I wrote it, I used the capital S, the uppercase S, to give you the sound of Sad. Fusha. Because Sad is an emphatic letter. Okay? It's not the lowercase s. Fusha. Fusha means formal. So whatever we did the introduction, it was formal. Fusha. And this is a very interesting thing to know, that if you speak this formal Arabic, so even Arab people, they will admire you, they will look you with the appreciation, and they will treat you as qualified and educated person.
So Imam Sahib,
yes.
You know the last letter in the Arabic script?
Uh-huh.
So is that the ha?
This is the ha.
It looks like, ya.
Okay, the last letter is ya, but before that is a ha. Let me write again very clearly. Like this.
Ah.
This is ha and then ya.
Okay, I got it.
And we will learn about this sign also that I am putting here.
Okay.
That is called dagger alif.
Yes.
Alif Sagira. Yes, Alif Sagira. Same thing, Alif Sagira. Yes. Yes.
Maqsura.
Maqsura, it has Alif Maqsura, yes. But Alif Maqsura does not have this symbol of the dagger Alif, you know. That is without any symbol. That is called Alif Maqsura. So that Alif is just the in the shape of Ya. So we will go in all the details about that. Okay. So, as we said, that our topic, that lesson was three consonants, ba, ta, sa, and the long vowels and the short ones, right? So they started with alif first, and alif comes from the long vowel, okay? So we need to get the introduction of alif. First thing to know, that alif is the very first Arabic alphabet, okay? Now, alif has two functions. This is very important note, very important point to be noted, that alif has two functions. One function is alif works as the long vowel that we are learning now. The other function of alif, that it works sometimes as the consonant. Okay. So write down these two points about alif. Or two duties of alif, or two functions of alif. One is as the long vowel, one is as the consonant. And let me add some more thing over here, because we are going to learn that also, that other two long vowels, vav and ya, they also work sometime as the consonant. Okay? So all these three long vowels, on one hand, they work as the vowels. On the other hand, sometimes they work as the consonant. So since we are getting all the information about alif now, so we will talk only about alif. And in the unit 1, we are getting the introduction of alif as the long vowel, not as the consonant. Now, we will come to the pronunciation of alif. When it comes to the pronunciation of alif, it has different pronunciations, and there are two major factors of these two pronunciations. One factor is the regional dialect, and the other factor is the surrounding consonant, that is neighboring to this alif. and I will explain both conditions. If the letter, this alif is coming with the letter ta, ta alif. So what is the surrounding consonant of alif?
Ta.
And ta is not emphatic letter, is a thin letter. In this case, we will pronounce alif also thin. We will say ta.
Ta.
Ta. However, if the alif, the same alif is coming with the letter to, that is the emphatic letter, then the alif automatically, the pronunciation of alif also will be a thick pronunciation, heavy pronunciation. Now we say to.
To.
To. So, if you follow the difference between the two alif, so this ta, it's coming with the thin letter, with the smiley face. So, this alif is called frontal. This quality of alif, it is called frontal quality. Frontal, because it's coming from the front of your mouth. Okay? And this alif that is coming with the ta, it will be called, this quality will be called deeper, deeper quality of alif. So remember that we have the two qualities of alif, one is frontal quality, one is deeper quality. Frontal quality comes with the non-emphatic letters, and the deeper quality comes with emphatic letters. Okay? And this is the reason if you are reading the Quran, you have to make this difference. And I will give you the example of this ta'alif in the Quran. There's a word in the Quran, taba. Taba. Taba is from tauba. Taba making repentance. Taba is the verb, past tense, for making repentance, and if it is referred to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means Allah accepted the tawbah. Allah accepted the repentance. So in one ayat of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the some sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, though did not participate in a ghazwa Tabuk, that was the very hardest, you know, expedition. They left, they stayed at home and they did not participate because of just their laziness. It was not any genuine reason for them not to participate. But when Rasulullah ﷺ returned from this ghazwa, so these three sahaba, they were very sincere and true sahaba. They realized their mistake and they did not make any excuse like other munafiqeen, the hypocrites. When the hypocrite they came, they said that we did not go because our family problems, I do not have anyone to take care of my family, I do not have anyone to take care of my business. So they had the excuse of business and the family. But these three sahaba, they said that we do not have any excuse whatsoever, this was our own fault that we did not go. And they were waiting. The Prophet ﷺ said, I am not going to make any decision about you, I am waiting from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And 40 days have passed and the orders were coming strictly for them, boycott them, even from their wives also told that leave them and go to your your mother's home or your father's home, your own home, and do not live with them. That was strict order. No one was greeting them, no one was talking to them, all these three sahaba. Then, and they were day and night, they were crying and they were asking the true repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and ultimately Allah accepted. So then Allah revealed this ayah, لَقَدْ تَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ وَالْمُهَاجِرِ. So if you are reading this ayah, then you will pronounce the quality of Ali, frontal quality, say تَابَ. However, if you are using the word تَابَ, is the contrast with this one, if you just add ba over here, it will become taba. Okay. Taba, if someone did a job very well, you say like in English, well done. Right? Well done. So then you say taba. He did well. And this word also, this word has been used in the Quran, but not in this Tawbah form. It is Tuibutum. Tuibutum. And where is the reference that when all the good people, the believers, they will go into the Jannah, they will be welcomed by the angels. And the angels will say, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْ رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرَىٰ حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا. When they will come to that, the doors of the Jannah will be opened for them. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا. And the guard who will be at the door of the Jannah, he will say, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ. Peace be upon all of you. You did well in your worldly life. Well done. And then he say, فَدْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. Okay, so this word is tibtum here, but however we are talking about alif, so if you are pronouncing it with alif, then you will make alif, the quality of alif, thick and say tawba.
Okay.
So this was about the pronunciation of alif. Now in eastern part of the Arab world, and you have map in your mind. We talked about the mind, okay, the map. So eastern part, Saudi Arabia, Syria, and the Iraq, and all those, Jordan and those states, they pronounce most of the time ta as the deeper quality. As the deeper quality. And if they are saying the word book like kitab, so they will say kitab, tab, like father in English. Father, the same way as we say father. But if you go to the western part of the Arab world, especially North Africa and Tunisia and Morocco and all those countries, they pronounce it A sound. Then they will not say kitab, they will say kitab, right? So it will be te, A sound, like bat, when we say the English word bat. So it will not be like father, it will be bat, te, that sound. So there will be this frontal quality, and the other one, ta, more farther in your mouth, it will be the deeper quality. So this is the pronunciation of alif. Yes.
So the pronunciation of alif,
yeah,
in both cases,
yeah,
is it prolonged? Is it ta?
Yes.
Ta?
Exactly. Yes. Very good. This is the duration of the long vowel, and we discussed in the first day about that. That the long vowel is about 2 fingers raising to be like 2 seconds. So in both cases the duration will be the same. Will be the same, yes.
Okay? So one question.
Yes.
As we explained about the tibkum. So is that a common word? Can you say if your child do a good job, you say tibkum?
Yes. You will say tibta, right? Yes.
But if you want to also say to your child, you've been forgiven for the mistake you have done, like your kindly father or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So can you say tibkum?
For the tawbah? No. Tawbah is just between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes.
That's not the forgiveness.
No. Yes. You have other words for that. One word is afautu. Afautu means I forgive you. Or another word is from safaha yasfahu safahtu. So there are other expressions, but not tawbah. Yes.
Okay. In my native country, most of the people when they read, they say what do hai wallayli iza saje.
Yes.
Okay. Ma wadaka rabbuka wa ma qale.
Qale. Yes.
Where is that from?
Yes. This is from the North African countries.
Okay.
From the western part of the Arab.
Okay.
Yes. Another way that we say ma salama, goodbye, right? So eastern part they say ma salama. Salama, this ending sound ma. Western say ma salame. Okay? They ma salame. So how this alif sound is changing.
So when the Quran is recited in both dialects, it's okay, right?
Okay, in the riwayat of the Hafs, that majority of the Muslims they recite the Quran, that is called riwayat of Hafs. That is the deeper quality of alif. Like kitab. Or ma salama, that sound. Or like wa duha, not wa duha. But in the varsh qiraat, that is another qiraat, there are 7 qiraat,
yes,
right?
Yes.
So varsh qiraat, that is followed mostly in Morocco and surrounding countries, they will pronounce that sound.
Okay.
Like he was giving the examples. Okay. Now, okay, so one more thing, because we are going in detail of all the letters, I would like you to make the topics and headlines that for each letter we will first discuss the pronunciation of that letter. Okay, so put the headline, pronunciation, okay, and check for every letter so that you make sure that you know the pronunciation of all the letters that we are going to discuss. The second thing, we will talk about different functions of the letters, if there are any. It will not be true for every letter, but some of them, like Alif has two functions, Waw has two functions, Ya has two functions. So we will talk about the functions of the letter. Okay. The third thing that we will talk about, the writing of that letter, how to write this letter. Okay. And the fourth thing, we will talk about every letter, that either is a connecting letter or non-connecting letter. Connecting letter or non-connecting. And it is very, very important to learn about this fact, connecting or non-connecting, because many mistakes in writing Arabic, they come because of this problem. People, they are not aware of the connecting and non-connecting. So what should you do from the beginning? That make like two basket. Okay, either two baskets if you are good in, you know, drawing, or just make two columns and your page like this. Put one side and make a headline or topic connecting letters. And on the other one, non-connecting. And make sure that you will bring that same page, same notebook every time, and you are going to go on that page every time when we are learning the new letters. So it will be explained that this letter is connecting or non-connecting. So if you find a connecting, then put in this basket. If it's a non-connecting, then put it over here. Now tell me, where are you going to put Alif? In which one?
Non-connecting,
yes, in this one. So you can make some, you know, like boxes. So this will be, one will be Alif. Because if you are going to write the four shapes of Alif, so it will be this one, and this one, and this one.
So that's one way.
Non-connecting means it can be connected with the previous letter but not with the following letter. And connecting means it is connected with both previous and the following letter. Okay. For example, the next letter will be Ba. So Ba is a connecting letter. Then you will put Ba in this box. Ba. First shape independent, then initial Ba, then medial Ba, then final Ba.
So the Alif, the last two part,
yes,
that's connecting to the previous letter.
Yeah, okay, but they are connecting only with the previous letter. They are not connecting. They are not connecting
forward,
with the following.
Yes. I see.
And this is the reason that if you are writing the word Kitab, again, I will give you the example. So you will write like that. So Alif is not connected with the following letter, but I have seen of my students, they made the mistake and not knowingly they connected, they wrote Kitab like that.
Wow.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
because yeah, they thought that in Arabic letters are connected, so they connect Alif also with the following letter. So be very careful that Alif is a non-connecting letter.
So when you connect it, it becomes Lam.
Yeah, well, if you connect this shape, it will become Lam. Yes. Now I will give you some homework also on page number 21. Page number 21, this is a drill number 1. Drill number one says hearing the frontal quality and the deeper quality of alif. So as we just explained about the frontal and the deeper quality, you will hear 12 words. In all those 12 words, every word carries the alif, right? So either when you hear, you will hear frontal quality of alif, or you hear the deeper quality of alif, depending on the surrounding consonant. So if the surrounding consonant will be emphatic letter, then that alif will be deeper. If the surrounding consonant is non-emphatic, then it will be frontal quality. So you need to circle D or F in your book. For the deeper alif, you circle D. For the frontal, you will circle an F. Okay. And writing alif is not a big deal. Mashallah, you already learned now and all four shapes. But read, I am giving you as a homework how to write this letter. And by the way, there is also calligrapher in your DVD. He is also Professor Al-Shannawi. Professor Al-Shannawi is very beautiful, his style of writing. So he made this letter alif in very calligraphic style. So if you can look at the DVD and imitate how he's writing, so you will learn, writing Arabic in beautiful way also. So it's another homework of the calligraphy, if you can do it, inshallah. Okay. Now, since we are approaching to the time of Salah, and inshallah, I will complete this discussion now next Sunday. So, the last thing we will do, go on page number 22 and look at the last line on page number 22. It is like a puzzle. It's a puzzle, Arabic puzzle for you. They are asking that count down all the alif in this line. How many alifs are there? So, start working that in, and you have only 30 seconds for that. Hold on. Let everyone come. After 30 seconds, I will ask. You already did? Okay, keep to yourself. Keep to yourself.
11. 13.
Okay, now. We are hearing now different numbers, so pay attention. Okay, so far most of the people said 13 and 11. You said 11. Other number? 13? Aapke 13? 13? You sure or you just copying her? Any other number?
12.
12, okay, very good. We got number 12 also. What is your thinking? 13. Okay. Sister Brandy? Still counting? Take your time. Yes. Yes. 12. Okay.
13.
Yes, the right answer is that is 13. It's not 12, it's not 11. Okay. So, if you want to clarify, inshallah, do it. Ask me next time. Also, inshallah, read about the letter Ba, Ta, Sa. It is not very much detailed introduction. These are easy letters. And we will finish, inshallah, this unit next Sunday. And keep doing work on your introduction with your street name as well. Okay. So, inshallah, we are concluding the class. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين